really quickly to our attorneys and ask each of you very quickly as a round, as a rapid fire, is what we saw from William Barr when he was questioned by Kamala Harris perjury or contempt of Congress in your view? And I'll start with you, Barbara.
Well, we'd have to know the facts. It's very difficult to prove perjury. You have to prove that he then and there knew what he was saying was false. But I think with further investigation, the case could be made.
Joyce?
I agree with Barb. This turns on what conversations Barr had with people inside of the White House or perhaps with people at DOJ on this same timeline. If he in any way had the suggestion planted that he should open investigations, and we know that he did, by the way, in his early days as Attorney General, he began to revisit all of these key steps in the Mueller report investigations. So if there's evidence that he lied in response to Kamala Harris, he could open himself up to prosecution.
And Paul, Michael Cohen testified that Donald Trump just let you know what he wants. He doesn't have to explicitly tell you what to do. There's a mob vibe to the way that he communicates with people what he wants. And William Barr wrote a memo saying, buddy, I'm going to do what you want. I'm going to give you what you need. Whatever you need, just hire me. It doesn't seem to me that much of a stretch to say that the collusion is sort of on the table, that he was coming in to go after the president's enemies and to protect the president's friends from going to prison or to lighten their sentences or to give them a break. It's clear that's all that he thinks his job is. He doesn't do any other job. So the question is, could he then be held accountable for lying to the United States Congress, in this case, to the senator, to Senator Kamala Harris?
You know, Trump has talked about how he wanted his own personal fixer. Trump used to be represented by Roy Cohn, and now Trump has his own mob lawyer in William Barr, who lies about everything. Barr lies about big things, like when he mischaracterized the Mueller report and when he claimed that the Obama administration was spying on the Trump campaign. And he lies about relatively small matters, like when he claimed that the U.S. Attorney Berman resigned when Berman didn't have to push back and say, no, you fired me. And so I don't think that we should believe anything this attorney general says. And the Congress, including the Senate, has to take that seriously. Our attorney general is undermining the rule of law.